Good morning. I just realized that I'm presenting on the day that I couldn't be there with you. I'm going to be there on the Friday, not the Thursday. So I was going to do this live because this is about live streaming, but ironically, I have to record it for you. Okay, so here it goes. Here we are, Code for Library, together but virtually. Hoping to find computer minds and share the technologies. Together, we're gonna find our way. Together, COVID's not here to stay. To learn all about those things we use every day. OBS together, you and I. I just realized I solved the karaoke online problem, in case you weren't aware that problem existed. Hello, do you miss library programs? Are you interested in reaching new audiences online but have a modest budget to do so? Do you want to host story times, author visits, or just spice up your webinars all without sharing germs? You may be interested in OBS Broadcasting Software Studio. With just a little practice and help from a plethora of online resources geared to Twitch streamers, you can be on your way to streaming live events on YouTube, Facebook, or Twitch. Hi, my name is Kevin. And today I want to talk to you about a fun little piece of software, free software, called OBS Studio. My interest in OBS Studio came from my desire to capture video game footage and upload it to my YouTube channel. My channel is called Kevinish at Sevenish, and my series of game videos is called Letters to a Young Gamer. I have literally dozens of views. Not only is OBS a great screen capture software, but it's also a very versatile on-the-fly editor for live streaming video. If you have ever visited the Amazon website Twitch TV, you will be familiar with the things that it can do. Most frequently, this involves showing a person playing video games live and interacting with an audience through a chat box. It's true. What these streamers accomplish every day, all day, for hours and hours on end is impressive. However, I have noticed that other entertainers and even political figures are embracing live streaming. Just to name a few, Alexandra Ocasio-Cortez and Jagmeet Singh recently played a game of Among Us together on Twitch. And my friend Eric Fell moved his D&D improv comedy show from the Rio Theater to Twitch. With OBS, you can prepare for your broadcast by setting up a variety of scenes that you can switch to. These scenes can include all manner of pictures, video, audio, and even application sources. All of these can be mixed together for your presentation. Sounds like rocket magic, doesn't it? Well, in fact, once you get the hang of it, it's not too tricky. Heck, even an old guy like me can learn it. I bet a lot of you have used PowerPoint for presentations and are even doing so today. I have myself too. You can be pretty creative with the old PPT, and I've seen impressive slideshows from Macs and Linux machines alike. With OBS, you can still switch to your PowerPoint, but you have the added benefit of being able to switch back to a webcam, or perhaps a beautiful spreadsheet to do a live demonstration of. In fact, you can select any specific window as a scene. So if you want to demonstrate a website, for example, or if you want to show a YouTube video after showing a spreadsheet, it's as simple as switching scenes. With OBS, if it's on your desktop, you can mix it into your broadcast. I didn't set this up. Bear with me. Now we're gonna switch to my not yet open YouTube scene. I may have to edit this. Where is the donut hole scene? There it is. Do you see that?
Odd.
Yes, you do. Okay. On the fly editing, ladies and gentlemen. This is live.
It is
Anything
an immovable
can
fact
go
that I killed
wrong.
Harlan.
Yes, you did. Yes, you did. Yes, you are. But I spoke in the car about the hole at the center of this donut. And what you and Harlan did that fateful night seems, at first glance, to fill that hole perfectly. A donut hole in a donut's hole. But we must look a little closer. And when we do, we see the donut hole has a hole in its center. It is not a donut hole, but a smaller donut with its own hole. And
so, yes, it's good at showing YouTube videos. It's also good for doing interviews with people. In Zoom, for example, you could lock your frames so that people's faces don't move around. And then have someone familiar with Photoshop create a branded transparent overlay for your guests. Would look something like this if I had guests. And then you can even switch to individual guests by switching the scene to zoom in on a particular person after you ask a question. Or you could even look directly into the camera for a powerful effect. Now for the grand finale of this presentation, before I take questions, which I can't, so maybe I'll take some questions Friday if anyone has any. This is the part I was dreading the most. I want to show you the back end of OBS Studio. And we'll look at a simple scene and just take it apart. Oh God, stare into the void. Embrace it. Don't be afraid. Yes. So this is OBS, and it's not too bad. So over here on the left-hand side, there's this little window called Scenes. And these are the scenes that I set up. And then next to that, this box here, the preview box, is obviously a preview of the scene before you make it live. And then over on the right-hand side, as we stare into infinity, that is what is live. And right at this moment, it's being recorded. I was hoping to send that directly to a share screen, which is possible. Took me a little bit of working around to do the share screen. I had to set up a virtual camera, but I won't go into that right now. So let's look at the PowerPoint window here, the PowerPoint scene. So yeah, if you're familiar with Photoshop, okay. So full disclaimer, I kind of cheated This wasn't a live PowerPoint application window. Sorry, I lied to you. I know. I've broken my trust with this group so many times that it's just irredeemable. But this is an image of PowerPoint, and I have it as the bottom frame, and then above that is my little webcam, video capture device, and then above that is a see-through border with these nice rose blossoms. So it's pretty simple. You just layer things. You can have moving images, like if you know After Effects, which I do not. In fact, all of these special effects I got online from a free site. But if you do know After Effects, that's great. I mean, you can do this yourself. So this concludes my presentation. And I think that was about 10 minutes. I timed it many times. I've run through this many times because I have had a few technical difficulties. Oh, let's transition this scene. Do you see that? Yes, I think you do. I'm not sure anymore. I've gone through the rabbit hole of Looking Glass. I don't know where I am anymore, but I hope this is filling your screen. I just wanted to highlight some of the tools I used. OBS Studio, the plug-in virtual camera. Voice Meter Banana was really useful for sound mixing. That's another free program that you can use to make all your system sounds, or to go through different channels, so I could play you music or things like that through Zoom. And then the Cherry Blossoms was created by this fellow on a YouTube channel called Stream Scheme. Okay, that's it. That's me. That's your presentation. Thank you so much. I hope you guys have a great first day on Code4Library. and I'll see you tomorrow. Bye-bye. Mm-hmm.